What up, y'all? Welcome back to Off the Bench. OTB, T-Bow Mario, Jake and Danny hanging out with you. So we just talked Saints with Nick Underhill, and I referenced an article that is absolutely fantastic. And it is by Luke Johnson. It's on NOLA.com right now, Times-Picayune, Saints by the Numbers, making numerical sense of an up-and-down 2021 season. And it gets into those numbers that we mentioned to start that interview, which is it's kind of insane. But the Saints right now, in terms of their point differential versus yardage differential, there's a pretty extreme disconnect. And like Nick said, maybe like an outlier of a game in the Carolina game plays into that. But at the same time, I mean, you lost on point differential as there in a significant way, in that you still sit here at fifth in the league at plus 7.2 on average. So, like, it doesn't tell the whole story. It wasn't just all some statistical outlier. And so that's the question that Luke Johnson attempts to answer in his piece. And the reason is pretty interesting, Jake. And I think it reinforces, first, just how important situational football is. And I think it reinforces, honestly, a lot of times what's been part of the problem with LSU this year when they've been bad. And how the Saints are winning games big, but still sometimes, you know, not like dominating the yardage. It's because situationally they are elite. When they get into the red zone, there is no team in the NFL right now that is better on either side of the ball than the New Orleans Saints. Listen to these numbers, Jake. So the Saints right now, when they get in the red zone, they score touchdowns 92.8% of the time. So if you let them down there, it is nearly a guarantee that they're going to get in the end zone. That is 31% better than the league average. Now, a lot of people say, yeah, well, it's Taysom Hill. And it absolutely is. It absolutely is. Taysom Hill is a huge X factor in that. I also, I go back to the Jameis 101 interview that we had this spring or summer or something, when I wish I could remember the exact stat, but he mentioned the fact that in his 5 years in Tampa that Jameis had actually been, maybe it was like top in the league, or it was like better than Brady. Like, he was one of the best red zone quarterbacks. Right. And if you think back this year, he had the one, you know, that was in God's hands and everything, the third and goal or third and nine or whatever. That was great. But he's actually been fantastic on third down when they've been in the red zone. They've thrown a lot of touchdowns this year in that situation. I'd actually love for someone to find the exact numbers. But so offensively, they've been elite there. I mean, is there anything else that you see in terms of why they're having so much success down there?
I think the personnel that you have is really set up for success outside of Jameis Winston in the red area. And you're talking about the success that he's had as well. Like, you have a running back that can run it or catch it. You have Taysom Hill, who's like this ultimate X factor as well. You have Johnson, who's this big body tight end that you can create mismatches with as well. So you have some pieces that actually play really well, even better in that part of the field than they do if you're just on the other 20. So I think it's just a combination of that and then not really thinking that Jameis would be the red zone quarterback that he is.
Yeah.
Because his skill set tells you everything kind of the opposite.
Like, yeah, you know, like when you Drew throw to be that many zone. Picks, it's supposed to get tough down there.
Yeah, and your arm is more about how far you can throw it than where you can pinpoint it, all those type of things. And it probably adds to the fact that they don't feel confident in kicking field goals either, so they probably work on red zone more than any other team. He's like, we can't kick field goals right now.
How about this? For touchdown rate, they have a 100% touchdown rate in goal-to-go situations on the season.
That's impressive.
So if they've ever gotten to the 10, they have never been kept out, which is pretty wild. The defense, on the other hand, again, number one, goal-to-go defense, teams have only scored touchdowns 44.4% of the time. So, I mean, the Saints are now elite situationally. And, again, all of these numbers and even further context all available from Luke Johnson in the Times pick. He really went off with this one. I think that what else was interesting in this? I mean, they're not rushing the passer well. That's kind of that's surprising.
It is, because you have – 4 first-round picks. You have 2 in Davenport, you have 1 in Cam, you have 1 in Turner. So it's 4 first-round picks, basically. You have tied into your defensive front.
The
so
Dead Boy Wolf joke. I did not make that up. He's the best.
That is troublesome.
It is.
And you also have some pretty good blitzing secondary pieces. You have some nice blitzing linebackers that are athletic enough to do it as well.
DeMar is one of the best in the league.
So the fact that you're not creating that is troublesome.
That is troublesome. I want to see, and remember, this is also an outlier for who the Saints have been recently. They've been one of the top pass rushers in the league the last couple of years in terms of sack rate. I think I want to see what this looks like when Marcus Davenport returns and David Onyemata. I mean, you got to remember that you're missing Onyemata, and he was having a lot of success even at the end or in the preseason. So he's a guy that can rush the passer inside or outside. But that is something, if the Saints ultimately want to make the playoffs, and then especially, like, I think they have a good chance of making the playoffs anyway, but if they want to make noise in the playoffs, that number will have to improve. And like the rest of this team, you would hope that it would improve as they, as guys return. And here's the craziest part about it. And this is what Luke ends the article on, but the number is one. The Saints? Okay, they have that plus 7.5-point differential. Number five in the NFL. The Saints have made one field goal in five games. One field goal. This ain't college. But they're playing. I mean, that's essentially like a college football league. They have one field goal in five games. They're just the fifth team since 1980 to make one or fewer field goals in their first five games, dude.
That's like...
And they're 3-2 with all these injured starters. Yeah. Like, Sean Payton deserves so much credit with all this, dude. It's crazy.
That, was it 16 or 17, whenever LSU's kicking was so bad? I think it was 17.
Yeah, it was the year you beat Auburn in the crazy comeback because Colt made the big ones randomly.
And coach was like, they asked him about the kicking situation. He's like, we're just going to go for it on every fourth down.
I mean, they did start to, too. Like, yeah, no, Colt was at like 60%. Yeah.
He just happened to make, the only kicks he made were to beat Auburn that year.
Hell yes, dude. Hey, Connor, better to make him then than miss
him. By the way,
he's
still kicking.
Yeah, is he Nebraska now?
Yeah,
he's still kicking. Is he their starting kicker? I heard he was, then he got benched.
I think he got benched, but he was.
Hey, he was that. One field goal. So, yeah, the picture that you could paint for Saints fans is actually, I mean, I guess you could take that number either way, but, like, you know you're going to get Will Lutz back, and that number will improve mightily. So, this is a Saints team that has...